Welcome to How It Works, a video series from LawSites and LawNext, in which you get to see hands-on demonstrations of legal tech products directly from their developers. In today's episode, we're taking a look at Briefpoint, an AI-driven tool that automates the process of drafting and responding to discovery requests, saving attorneys precious time that they can devote to more bespoke work. Joining me to tell us all about Briefpoint and how it works is Nathan Walter, the CEO and co-founder of the company. Nathan, welcome to the show.
Glad to be here, Bob.
Well, before we launch into this demonstration, can you kind of give us a little bit of an overview of Briefpoint and what you do?
Yeah. Briefpoint drafts discovery responses and discovery requests. It's an out-of-the-box solution, and you can log in from any state in the U.S. or D.C., upload a PDF, and you get, in minutes, a completed Word document with either a discovery response or a set of discovery requests, and that's what I'm about to show you today.
All right. Well, why don't we launch into it? Why don't you show us how it works?
Let's do this. So what you're seeing here is where you'll land when you create a new trial account with Briefpoint, and this is basically my first login. So the first thing I'm going to show is how to draft a discovery response. Now, normally to draft a discovery response, you get a PDF from opposing counsel, you open a Word document, you format it, you put it into a master caption, and you start copying and pasting stuff together. With Briefpoint to draft a discovery response, all you need to do is upload your opposing counsel's discovery request PDF. These don't need to be OCR'd. They can be blurry, they can be skewed. Honestly, we trained an AI for a year and a half on computer vision in order to extract the data from these PDFs accurately. Let me show you what I mean. So here's my opposing counsel's RFP. Click Get Started. The first step, we just confirm information we pulled out of this document, like case information, service information, party information. And now what we've done is taken all the requests from my opposing counsel's PDF and we put them into a list for our users to respond to one after another. Now to respond to these, there's a couple things you can do. You can add your objections by selecting your objections from the menu of options on the left. This is our out-of-the-box content, but it's fully customizable. Under privilege, for example, there's a drop-down where we have marital privilege, tax return, and every other flavor of privilege. You can make all of this content your own and save it to your account. So when you or someone else at your firm is selecting these objections, it's inserting your work product automatically. For actual responses, we have some canned responses. This is an RFP, so maybe you're unable to produce and you can say the documents were destroyed. This looks good. The more interesting way of responding is clicking suggest. And when you click suggest, Briefpoint will review the request, select the objections from the menu of options on the left for you, and then write each objection and argue why each objection applies to the request. So I click a suggest, it selects, and now it tailors. The tailoring is done primarily to protect you against boilerplate objection arguments, because these aren't copy and pasted, they're written from scratch and justified in light of the contents of the request.
So they won't be the same every time?
It's never, almost never the same at any time. And this also throws a wrench in your opposing counsel's review process, because if they're used to just seeing the same objections over and over, they can kind of go into a pattern. You can at least prevent them from making boilerplate grounds for compulsion, if that is the case.
Right.
we like to make things difficult for people that aren't using Briefpoint. So you could also, of course, add to any of this. You can remove these objections. It's just getting the objections out. And if I click open in Word now, you'll see a Word document where we have all these requests and then two sets of objections. But before I show you this Word document that we've created so far, I want to talk about getting substantive responses. Now, normally to get a substantive response from an interrogatory, for example, you have to call your client, explain to them what the discovery is asking, and then get your client's response and add it into the response document. So Briefpoint does that, and it's through a function called send to client. And when I click send to client, I'm going to send these requests to a client, myself. I'm going to show you what it looks like from the client's perspective, and then I'm going to come back into Briefpoint and show you where your client's responses go. So you click send to client. When you do this, you can choose which requests or interrogatories to send, and Briefpoint will automatically translate these requests into plain English for your client's benefit. So when your client's looking at these requests, we remove the legalese, we simplify it all through our translate to plain English function. Once you're ready, you click next, you confirm your client's email, you hit open email, and you send your client this email. We don't actually communicate with your client. Rather, we facilitate your communication with your client. So you just click open email and send, and now you've sent your client this email, when the email has a link and a code for your client to access and answer the discovery questions. So now I'm the client. I go to this link. I enter the verification code. I have these discovery responses, and your client doesn't see any of the objections. All they see is the request and then the plain English explanation in blue. While your client is going through these discovery responses, we show them their progress, and on the right here, we show them all their prior responses. So if it's maybe it's asking for a date of execution or a VIN number, and your client thinks, oh, I already put that information in number one, they can just copy from their first response or any other response and put it in there so that now they can get through their discovery while, you know, keeping their story straight. Not that they would have to exert effort to do that, but also getting through a little bit faster.
Are they able to upload documents there at the same time?
The upload document function is coming next year.
Okay.
Yes. Once your client is finished, they're brought to a review page. Briefpoint shows them everything they've done, and they can either save and come back or submit it. I'm going to submit it. Once your client has submitted their discovery, Briefpoint emails you, and that email says, 1, 2, 3, your client submitted their responses. You can click the link that Briefpoint sends you, and it'll bring you back into your response document, but now your client's response is on the right. And if you click copy and add, it will insert your client's response into the actual response, so you can tweak those responses as necessary. So now responding to discovery with Briefpoint can be as easy as clicking suggest, copy and add. Now I want to show you the Word document we've created to date, or so far, and to do that you click open in Word. And when I click open in Word, in about a second, a Word document will download to your computer. So I click open in Word, the Word document's downloaded, and now I'm going to open this document. So this is a document we just generated. The caption page is completed, and you know, because we uploaded a California document, the formatting is California formatting. If I had uploaded a New York document, it would have been New York formatting, Texas formatting. We automatically identify the jurisdiction when you upload a document, and then we apply that jurisdiction's formatting rules and customs so that you don't need to spend time reformatting anything Briefpoint generates.
And you do that for all 50 states?
All 50 states and DC, exactly. We have preliminary statement and general objections, which can be customized. And then here we have the first request and the objections we clicked on in the first part, the second request, and these are the objections we generated, and then your client's response is here. Number three, the client's response is there. Number four, we didn't get to, so it's blank, but we still did what you might spend 15, 20 minutes doing, and we inserted all the requests and left space for the responses for the whole document, which amounts to, in this case, 30 pages of content that you can get out the door in Briefpoint with a single PDF upload in about 30 seconds of time. It's pretty simple stuff.
That's fantastic.
But we also do something else. So we also propound discovery. We generate the outgoing discovery. So let me go back into Briefpoint and show you what that looks like now. Okay, back in Briefpoint.
Okay, yeah, I had a question for you before you go into the propounding, which is on the canned responses. I think I heard you say that the law firm can tailor those to their own language. Is that right?
Everything can be customized, and that's a great question. So let me show you where you can customize things. There's two places you can customize any of your content. For canned responses, you can select the edit pencil here, and you can customize your content and click save and add, and it saves to your account. Or you can go to your library, which is over here, and see all of your work product. And in your library, there's additional customization features. So if we have this cumulative objection and you say, you know what, I want to set my cumulative objection for everyone in my law firm, you click the edit pencil and you click firm library. And now this objection and however you phrased it is applied to everyone at your firm. This is also true for responses and canned responses and everything else. You can also filter the content by document type. So if you have sets of objections that only apply to RFAs, but not interrogatories, or responses that only apply to one or the other, you can select that here. And then your menu, while you're responding on the left, actually adjusts depending on what document you're responding to.
Great,
fully customizable. Back to propounding discovery, which is another customizable feature. The way that you propound discovery is you select propound discovery, and you upload a PDF of your pleading. So plaintiff side, upload your complaint. Defendant, upload your cross complaint or answer. Here I'm a plaintiff, so I'm gonna upload a complaint. And Briefpoint's gonna pull out information from the complaint, organize it. We're gonna review this information and then use that information to draft your outgoing sets of discovery. And now it's done, so we're gonna click get started. On the left, we have a preview of my complaint. On the right, we're confirming some information we've pulled out. This is, you know, propounding, responding party. We have a analysis of the actual case itself, including lists of injuries. And if you want to add anything in here that is going to be the target of your discovery, but maybe is not listed, you can add additional details here, and whatever you've added will also be addressed in the outgoing sets of discovery. The third step is just all of our allegations, and you can of course add another allegation. And now to draft your RFAs, interrogatories, and RFPs, you check those boxes and hit confirm. Briefpoint will do the rest. One thing Briefpoint is doing right now is while we're generating these discovery requests, we have an objection identification system reviewing every request for objection. And if it detects an objection, it will rewrite that request to evade objection. So what we're about to see are three sets of discovery that are very particularized and designed to reduce the good faith grounds your opposing counsel has for objecting to and dragging their feet on responses. Here's our set of RFAs. And if we look at the RFAs, we can see, okay, they have sites to the vehicle code. They have very specific details about the accident. Everything from the car license plate numbers. These are details that would be kind of annoying to type in for every request. We do that automatically. Interrogatories, the same deal. We have very specific grounds identifying, okay, who are the witnesses? Talk to me about the facts, all of that stuff. And to draft these interrogatories, you click open in Word, and then you download an interrogatory, request for production, open in Word. We just downloaded a request for production. RFAs, open in Word. We just drafted three sets of discovery, all, again, within a few minutes of your account. But there's more. If you want to add in some interrogatories that you always want to ask. Now, and this is a California case, so there's special interrogatories. If you were in another state, it would just be interrogatories. If you want in to add in interrogatories that you say, you know what, I'm probably going to use this again, you can click Add New Request, add in a rog I might use again. If you select Add to Library for Future Use, Briefpoint will add this to your firm's library, so the next time they're responding to discovery, they can click Add from Library and then drag and drop in their general interrogatories or your canned or template interrogatories, and you get your template interrogatories and the tailored interrogatories all in one place. So now if we look at these documents, and I'll show you these interrogatories now, we see, again, caption page completed, definition section, and then we have all the interrogatories listed out one after another. So you can get your outgoing sets of discovery done the same breath you file your complaint, and these are all very detailed, and I think they're all pretty good, actually.
That's pretty impressive. So whether you're looking to draft interrogatories or respond to interrogatories, you've got the tool for them. I think all you need now is a tool for judges to automatically decide discovery disputes after the parties start fighting over these things.
Well, it's funny you mentioned that. So next year, we're actually going to be drafting a motion to compel module, and we're training the AI on decisions that judges have made approving or disapproving grounds for compulsion, and that's going to be the basis for generating arguments for compulsion. Hopefully judges will use it. We'll see.
There you go. All right. Well, you can send me a commission on that one, I think. And that's really cool. I mean, I'm curious what you found you're hearing from your customers in terms of what kind of time savings they get from using this.
So it depends on the complexity of the document, right? So if we're looking at our RFP and you're adding your objections, there's a big time save on the response to request for production document. And there's also a time save for generating the outgoing sets. But we don't do any document review. So the work that's related to these discovery documents still needs to be done, like the document review, right? But just as far as the document goes, we're looking at 80-85% time saves per document, which ultimately amounts to several hours per document.
Yeah, that's really fantastic. Well, thanks. Anything else you'd like our viewers to know before we finish up here?
Yes. Briefpoint is free to try. No credit card required. You go to briefpoint.ai, you click get started, and you get set up with a trial account. It's not one of those things where if you don't cancel, we charge you. If there's no credit card, you can test it completely free and decide whether or not it's something that would help your practice.
Great. Well, Nathan, thanks so much for taking the time to share this today.
Thank you, Bob. Appreciate it.
That's it for this episode of How It Works. You can find the full series at directory.lawnext.com under the Resources tab or on YouTube. This is Bob Ambrosi. Thanks for watching.